afternoon and welcome to St. John the Evangelist Catholic Church. Please rise and join in singing if you're familiar with Gathering Evening.
Thank you. God's Son's thought that those who believe in Christ may receive freedom and an everlasting inheritance through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, you son of man, I have appointed watchmen for the house of Israel. When you hear me say anything, you shall warn them for me. If I say of the wicked, O wicked one, you shall surely die. And you do not speak out to dissuade the wicked from his way, the wicked shall die from his guilt. But it will hold you responsible for his death. But if you were warned the wicked, trying to turn him from his way, and he refuses to turn from his way, he shall die for his guilt, but you shall save yourself. Word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, owe nothing to anyone except to love one another. For the one who loves another has fulfilled the law. The commandment, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not kill, you shall not steal, you shall not covet, and whatever other commandments there may be, summed up in this saying, namely, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Love does no evil to the neighbor. Hence, love is the fulfillment of the law. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus said to his disciples, if your brother sins against you, go and tell his fault between you and him alone. If he listens to you, you have won over your brother. If he does not listen, take one or two others along with you, so that every fact may be established on the testimony of two or three witnesses. If he refuses to listen to you, tell the church. If he refuses to listen even to the church, then treat him as you would a Gentile or a tax collector. Amen, I say to you, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Again, amen, I say to you, if two of you agree on earth about anything for which they are to pray, it shall be granted to them by my heavenly Father. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them. The Gospel of the Lord. The first 4 years that I was in high school seminary, our study halls were always mandatory. At the same time, they were always modified. They were always, there was always one of the priests, one of the old students there to monitor the study hall, just to make sure that everybody was being quiet and supposedly studying. Okay, now after those first 4 years, our administration decided they were going to introduce the responsibility program. Namely, we the actions of our fellow seminary. If someone were just cutting up in study hall, distracting others, then it was our responsibility to exercise eternal correction, point out to that one so that he was out of line and he was distracting everything else. Now that would have worked theoretically, except for the fact that the vast majority of people in study hall were cutting up anyway. And of course, if you ever tried to use this so-called fraternal correction, you just got told to shut up yourself and mind your own business. This fraternal correction thing just did not work verbally. Now, one of the things that I remember studying during one of those study halls was in psychology. There was an example of these two children who had been lost in the forest shortly after the birth. Now, they were found 7 or 8 years later. Apparently, they had been nurtured by some mammal animal, possibly primates, possibly wolves. But somehow or another, they received enough nurture to survive. The only thing is, they did not know how to speak at all. You know, we tend to think that speech is something that comes natural to human beings. We have to be taught how to speak by being shown how to do that through the example of others. Also, two children did not walk upright. All the other animals that surrounded them, they ran, walked on all four. In fact, the little calves, like the knee down to the foot, hadn't even developed because they were very seldom used. Because they ran on all fours, just like all the other animals. The whole point is very simple. We have to be shown how to be human beings. It doesn't just come automatically. It doesn't simply come in virtue of the fact that we are human, therefore we're going to act like humans. It's something we have to be shown for us to truly learn it. Now, you heard in today's gospel, where Jesus is telling us, if someone sins against us, then we should correct the person. On the other hand, if he doesn't listen, then bring 2 or 3 witnesses. If that doesn't help, then bring him before the whole church. Actually, I'm not sure if that one works anymore either. Kind of reminds me of study hall, where most of the people who are supposed to be studying and practicing for fraternal correction work. I think what this also tells us is, if we, as believers of God's church, are going to show the beauty of our faith to the world, preaching is not quite going to get the job done. I'm afraid we're going to have to do fraternal correction by example, namely allowing others to see the beauty and the truth of the manner in which we love our lives. Probably some of you who also have been read back in the lack of study hall have heard of this fellow G.A. Chesterton. One time he was in a public debate over the merits of religion. And the guy with whom he was debating pointed out to him, look, Christianity has never worked. Chesterton said, well, that's true. Christianity has never worked because it's never been tried. Obviously, then what today's gospel called for fraternal correction tells us is we need to look at our own lives and make sure that we're not simply teaching by the words we speak or the beliefs we claim to follow, but obviously we need to look at our lives and make certain we are teaching by the example that we set. Obviously, through our lives, we need to allow others to see the beauty and the truth of our belief. If I might use the G.K. Chesterton story, what we need to do is show to the world that Christianity truly does work, namely, when it's truly lived. Since it is our faith that enables us to live the beauty of our church family, let us now join and together pray the profession of our faith. Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, without salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became a man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, and with the Father and the Son, adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Seeking to live in unity of our faith, let us now present to our Heavenly Father our prayers and our petitions. That our individual labor may help bring to completion the gift of God's creation, we pray to the Lord. That this Labor Day weekend will place our work efforts within the plan of Almighty God for His kingdom, we pray to the Lord. That together, as God's children, we might lead each other to repentance and to divine grace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That we will fulfill the law of God by loving our neighbor as we love ourselves. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That we may be spared the loss of life and property during this earthly season. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our younger parishioner who will receive the Holy Eucharist for the first time today, that this may be the first of many times that he will receive the body and blood of the Lord Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
The special intentions requested for this afternoon's Mass of Gaetano and Clausie's families, for Jack Austin and their John Terrio families, for Johnny and Larsa, and thanksgiving for our PSR and our RCI Academy, for our own individual intentions, as well as our personal prayers, we pray to the
Lord.
Eternal Father, you bless us with goodness and your grace. You enable us to share and live the beauty of our belief. Grant our prayers and our petitions, so that living the unity of our church family, we might show the world your beauty, your truth, and your presence, as we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Everyone, as we announced last weekend, we are still obviously collecting financial donations to be used in the Lake York Diocese, those who have suffered through Hurricane Mark. We'll take our normal offertory collection, first of all, this afternoon. Once that has been completed, the ushers will combine first offertory collection. We would ask you to then come forward with the second collection, namely the one that will be used to gather from and be sent to the Diocese of Lake York.
Thank you.
God of all creation, through your goodness we have a spread to offer, which earth is given and human hands is made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed you, God of all creation, through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hand. It will become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be acceptable to you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. That wash away my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. My brothers and sisters, since these gifts are created, now represent ourselves and our lives, which we offer to God our Father, I ask you to pray, brethren, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Let us pray. O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty. And by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united, mind and heart, through Christ our Lord. And may the Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right to give you thanks, truly just, give you glory, Father, most. For you are the one God, living and true, abiding in truth for all eternity, dwelling in unapproachable light. Yet you who alone are good, the source of life, have made all that in, so that you might fill your creatures with a blessing, and bring joy to many of them by the glory of your life. So in your presence are countless hosts of angels who serve you day and night, and gazing upon the glory of your faith, glorify you without ceasing. With them, we too confess your name in exaltation, giving voice to every creature under heaven as the crown. Human nature in all things but sin. The glory he proclaim the good news of salvation, to prisoners' freedom, and to the soul for joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death. And rising from the dead, he destroyed and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us, he sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits for those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, may the same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, O Lord Jesus Christ, for the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. When the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father, most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, taking a chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me. If we seek to live for beauty and the unity of our faith, then let us proclaim the mystery of our faith. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Thank you. I ask all of you would please remain in your pew, the receptor of all of you. If you would simply come to the right-hand side of each pew where you were seated, communion minister myself will come to you one pew, one person at a time. After you receive the Holy Eucharist, please return to your pew by simply reentering opposite.
I
would invite those of you who are viewing at home and unable to receive the Blessed Sacrament sacramentally to now join me in prayer of spiritual communion. Most Holy Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive the sacrament, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. May I never be parted from you. Amen. Let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gift that we may merit an eternal share in his life, because he is and reigns forever and ever. Everyone, we have three rather lengthy announcements, but important. Any adult interested in the possibility of becoming Catholic is asked to contact Father Matt at the church office about our St. John RCIA program, which begins Wednesday, September 9th. Parents of uncatechized children ages 8 through 13 can also contact Father Matt about registration for the RCIC program for children. Also, please remember to make your hurricane relief donation to the Lake Charles Diocese by accessing the website of our own diocese at diobr.org. That's diobr.org. The Give Now button will appear immediately and allow you to make your contribution. Donations can also be made by placing an envelope labeled Hurricane Relief in any future offertory collections. Finally, in addition to our special second collections over these last 2 weekends for Hurricane Laura and Victims, we also begin this week, starting Monday, Labor Day, to collect items for house cleaning and gutting. Items can be brought to the St. John Activity Center any weekday between 5 and 7 o'clock p.m. or any weekend within 1 hour after the conclusion of our Saturday and Sunday Mass. All donated items will be picked up each Monday morning and delivered directly to churches in Lake Charles for distribution. Also, please see page 8 of this week's bulletin for a listing of the items that are needed for the house cleaning and gutting. Finally, I'd like to present today's first Eucharist recipient with his first communion certificate.
Lord, hear our prayers.